Performance USA, the greatest entertainers in America, is requested by you, the fighting men of the United States Armed Forces throughout the world. Command Performance, presented this week and every week till it's over, over there. Okay there, men, it's Command Performance time, so come and get it from the USA. And that goes for every son and daughter of Uncle Sam around the globe, and for all of you in all the United Nations who are lined up beside the men who are lined up against the Axis. Again tonight, your big show, presented by the Special Service Division of the War Department, is playing to a full house of servicemen and holding a royal flush in music. And don't ever forget it, those swell letters you write in are the aces in our deck. And dealing right off the top, here's the lovely star whose trumps in the hearts of thousands of you. By worldwide command of the AEF, your mistress of ceremonies, Jeanette Macdonald.
Thank you, Ken Carpenter. From Stalingrad to Auckland, and from North Island to North Africa, to points west of the Golden Gate and east of Our Lady out there in New York Harbor, to the north and to the south of the equator, it's love from the USA to the AEF. In your history books, command performance was always for the king and queen. Well, it's still that way, only the king of command performance, USA, is crowned with an overseas helmet and wears the royal blue and khaki of Uncle Sam. And the queen's in the uniform of the Army and Navy nurse. And Hollywood is the royal court of entertainment that's yours to command. Our first command tonight comes from a stately palace known as Hut 403 on Island X, somewhere in the Pacific. And bears the great seal of Slick, George, Three-Striper, Cricket, Woodsy, and Big Gun. And we hear echoes of the same request from APO 27 and Milton Ford and from Carol James at APO 812. One of the big hit tunes here at home, sung by a girl who's a hit from coast to coast, Why Don't You Fall in Love with Me, with the Command Performance Orchestra and Dale Evans.
You're not in love with anyone else. Why don't you fall in love with me? You're driving me crazy, baby, trying to guess. Will you tell me no, or will you tell me yes? You gotta go overboard for someone someday. Believe it or not, it's bound to be. As long as you're not in love with anyone else, why don't you fall in love with me? Why do you try to make me guess? Now will you tell me no, or will you tell me yes? Don't you know it's bound to be? As long as you're not in love with anyone else, why don't you fall in love? Why don't you fall in love with me? See here, you darling, such and such. See here, I love you very much. Someone someday, believe it or not, it's bound to be. As long as you're not in love with anyone else, why don't you fall in love with me?
And many, many thanks. Now, men, a letter from Captain R.S. Saunders at APO 863. Dear Command Performance, there's one voice that I would like to hear above all others, the sound of a baby's cry. That would be welcome music to many of us who haven't heard it for many months. At least I know the sound of my baby's voice would be a thrill beyond description. Well, Captain, it's quite a coincidence. Command Performance is a universal program, and right at this time, your baby speaks a very universal language. Listen. For the personal appearance of that star, we thank the radio engineers. Apropos of the same topic, hundreds of you have written to Command Performance asking Virginia O'Brien to sing Rockabye Baby, as only she can sing it. So here she is, Virginia O'Brien.
Rockabye Baby on the treetop, when the wind blows, the cradle will rock, rock, rock it, baby. Rock-a-bye, baby, on the treetop. When the wind blows, woo, your little cradle will rock. Oh, rock it. When the bough breaks, new cradle will fall. Down will come my baby, my baby, my little baby. Down will come my baby, baby and the cradle and all. Go to sleep, go to sleep, go to sleep. Close your eyes and go to sleep while Mammy tries to sing a lullaby. Lullaby, lullaby. Mammy's gonna rock you to sleep. Lullaby, bye, bye, baby. Rock, 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 cradle. Sleep, 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 Jackson. Shoot the talcum to me, Malcolm.
Thanks, Virginia O'Brien. Virginia will be back in a moment with another song that you've asked for. But now we're calling the Canadian Bomber Boys and Sergeants Patch, Clark, Whalen, and Vatch with good old 426. And Bill Love, a Detroit American in the Canadian Army overseas. And Hollis A. Smith, up there in the medical dispensary at Argentia. Hope that leg is improving, Hollis. And Mr. Dyson at Maidstone, Kent, in England. We're very proud that Command Performance helps you to feel closer to us over here. For Corporal Travis at APO 802, and Jerry Oppenheim and the men at 946, and Corporals Page and Eager with the Royal Air Force in West Africa, it's the hot violin of Eddie Saul, backed up by his entire orchestra. Sigoin in rhythm. Thank you. thank you, Eddie South and your orchestra. And we'll run a second heat in just a moment. Goodness, three orchestras here tonight. Well, right here, men, command performance fills orders from hundreds of you, including Sergeant Williams at 962, L.J. Farina at Fort Shafter, Sergeant Weston at Oahu, the New Harlem Grove Trotters in North Africa, the Bama Boys in the British Isles and India, and from three Hoosiers who've become proud fathers since leading Indianapolis. The orders being for the combination of that beautiful old song, On the Banks of the Wabash, and the one and only Mills Brothers.
Though the moon was shining bright along the Wabash, from the field there comes the breath of new mown hay. Through the sycamore, the candlelights are gleaming. On the banks of the Wabash,
Brothers. That was very, very sweet. It's a hello next to the Chow Hounds at APO 948. Pete, Yarbo, Windy, Kirsch, Porky, and Doy. To Carol and the gang in Barracks 149 down there in the Caribbean. For many thousands of you men of the USA who write to Command Performance, telling of the wonderful friends you're making in the great Latin American nations to our south, here's still another band you've asked for, playing one of the current hit songs, Eddie LeBaron and his orchestra, and Brazil. Oh. Our thanks to Eddie LeBaron and your orchestra. Well, men, that special girlfriend of yours is back again. Before she sings another of the songs she made famous in pictures, I think she'd better catch up on some of her correspondence. Front and center again for Virginia O'Brien. Come on.
Thank you, Jeanette Macdonald. Love to the Fuzzy Wuzzy Bunch in Australia. Thanks to Ray Daves, Rex Arnold, and the gang at APO 944. Yes, Ray, this will be for Adeline, too. My best to that Eagle Squadron boy in County Kildare and Canadian Brady. That goes for you, too. Hello, Given and Company at APO 845. I'll send that picture and one of Betty Hutton, too. But make up your minds, blondes or brunettes. And A.J. Stessville at APO 40. The guy's in the infantry is top man around here and don't think he isn't. But all of you are darn swell to write to me all those letters, and while you're out knocking out Nazis and Japanese, I'll keep on knocking out tunes to fill up your spare time. And here's one on account of you ask for it. Captain? Carry me back to old Virginia. There's where the cotton and the corn and taters grow. No place on earth do I love more sincerely than old Virginia, the state where I was born. Carry me back to old Virginia, that's my home. There's where the cotton and the corn and taters grow, mostly corn. There's where the birds warble sweet in the springtime. There's where this old lonely heart I'm long to go. There's where I labored so hard for old Massa, day after day after day in the fields of yellow corn, more corn. No place on earth do I love more sincerely than old Virginia. Not Kentucky. Than old Virginia. Virginia, that's the state where I was born. See?
Thank you, Virginia O'Brien. It's a shortwave call here to 23 Jersey men down in the Caribbean with a bombardment unit verbally camouflaged as Robin's Country Club. And hello to G.I. Joe Canata. and the censor who approved your request with a big definitely for 825-961, for Box 17 at Pearl Harbor, and for Bill Bailey from Bellingham, Washington, now in London. It's a return command performance for Eddie South and his orchestra, doing the St. Louis Blues.
Thank you.
Then it isn't the easiest matter in the world to follow that rendition of St. Louis Blues by Eddie Smith South and his orchestra. But hundreds of you from pole to pole have asked me to sing the Ave Maria. And I should like to do it for you now. And I want to tell Clive Waite down there in Belize, British Honduras, that I'm singing it for him. And my Captain Jean Raymond somewhere in England. And Captain Dunkel at the Air Base Hospital at APO 845. And Sergeant Troyer, it's for you too. But especially it's for one of Uncle Sam's Marines, Private Gregory of Harlan, Kentucky. And every Marine at Vigay's Island knows the reason why. Gounod's Ave Maria. Much. And now, this is Jeanette Macdonald speaking for all of us on Command Performance, saying thanks to you men for those wonderful letters you write in care of this station, or Special Service, Los Angeles, USA. Sending the best of the best from over here, and asking God's blessing on each one of you over there. Good night.
This program is produced for the men of the Armed Forces of the United Nations by the Special Service Division of the War Department of the United States of America. This broadcast is a part of our English language shortwave service.